Today I'm going to show you how to do rhythmic LFOs using Quad LFO, the LFO phase expander, Babel, and we're going to use the harmonic shift oscillator as something to drive, something to put the rhythmic LFO onto. So, first thing, if we combine these LFOs with a regular mixer, because they're sine waves, all we're going to get back is sine waves at a different phase. So, instead, we're going to use Babel, which will give the maximum for any, the minimum for all, or exclusive sum, we'll see, does something a little bit different. So, when we put all these LFOs, or all these phases, into Babel, see, we get out something where it's just grabbing the top of each wave. Now that's any, which is maximum, so it's the maximum value. You can see instead we used all, the minimum value. We get a much lower wave, but it is peakier. But we're going to use any for this. Phases, as you can see, going at different times, and we can just use these phase shifts to shift them around, put them at the time they want. Exclusive sum will do some neat quasi wave folding types of things. You can hear how this would be a good pulse to use for some kind of song or something. So that's pretty much all there is to it. Use Babel inputs, we get the mix of the sine waves either as the maximum, the minimum, or this exclusive sum value, the middlemum, if you will, and feed that into some control, get a nice rhythm going, automatic rhythm. Now one of the things you can do with the Quad LFO is because you can select square wave on the LFO without affecting the waveform of these, you can get this rhythmic LFO that is then synced to the clock. So we'll start the clock going. And now we'll build an LFO out of the remaining three phases. Of course, you can also get a mix of rhythmic and not rhythmic stuff by adding an LFO of a different speed.